How black tea affects you based on how long you brew it. Black tea is a popular drink all over the world, but it's more than just a soothing drink. The time it is made has a big effect on how it tastes, smells, and what health benefits it has. We'll talk about how brewing time changes black tea and give you some tips on how to get the most out of your cup. How to understand black tea. It's important to know what black tea is before getting into brewing times. Like green, white, and oolong teas, black tea comes from the leaves of the Camellia sinensis plant. The way black tea is made is what makes it unique. The leaves are fully oxidized, which means they are out in the air until they turn dark. This gives them strong tastes and qualities. How the time you brew black tea affects it. 1. Taste and strength. One clear change that happens with black tea brewing time is that the taste and strength change. Here's how it works. Short brewing time, 1 to 2 minutes. Tea that has only been made for a short time is usually light and delicate. The tea is not as strong, and the tastes are not as strong either. This is great for people who like a light taste. 3 to 4 minute medium brewing time. For many tea drinkers, this is the best temperature. The tea gets a well-balanced taste, with a good amount of strength and smell. There are tannins in the tea, which make it astringent, but they are not too strong. Brewing time, 5 minutes or more. The tea gets strong and full-bodied. When you let coffee steep for longer, more tannins come out, giving it a stronger, sometimes bitter taste. This is great for people who like their tea strong and don't mind it being a little bitter. 2. The amount of caffeine. Black tea's caffeine amounts change based on how long it is brewed. How to do it? Short brewing time, 1 to 2 minutes. Because less caffeine is taken out, the tea is a weaker stimulant. This might be good for people who are allergic to caffeine or who just need a mild boost. 3 to 4 minute medium brewing time. This has a modest amount of caffeine. Just enough to make you feel more alert without being too much. Brewing time, 5 minutes or more. Longer brewing times get the most energy out of the coffee. Because of this, the tea is a stronger stimulant, like a strong coffee. 3. The amount of antioxidants. Black tea is good for you because it has antioxidants. Oxidative stress is something that can happen in the body and can cause a number of long-term illnesses. How much antioxidants you get from your tea can also change based on how long you let it steep. Short brewing time, 1 to 2 minutes. A faster brewing time might not get as many antioxidants out of the coffee, which means it has fewer health benefits. 3 to 4 minute medium brewing time. This amount of time extracts a lot of antioxidants, which is a good mix between taste and health benefits. Brewing time, 5 minutes or more. It is possible to get even more vitamins from longer brewing times. But some people might not like the tea as much now that it's more bitter and astringent. 4. Release of nutrients. Black tea has more good things in it than just caffeine and vitamins. It has flavonoids, amino acids, minerals, and more. How these nutrients are released also depends on how long the coffee is brewed. Short brewing time, 1-2 minutes. Fewer nutrients are extracted, so the health benefits are lower. 3 to 4 minute medium brewing time. In this area, nutrients are extracted most efficiently, giving you a good amount of compounds that are good for your health. Long brewing time, 5 plus minutes. Gets the most nutrients out of the coffee, but some people might not like the strong taste. The science behind how long it takes to brew. Let's look at the science behind why the time you make black tea matters. Polyphenols, such as catechins and tannins, caffeine, and amino acids are some of the chemicals that are found in tea leaves. These chemicals break down into the water at different rates when you make tea. Polyphenols are. These are what give the tea its bitter and astringent taste. Because they break down slowly, longer boiling times make teas with more polyphenols, which make them stronger and astringent. Coffee. Since this drug breaks down pretty quickly, even a short time of brewing can release a lot of caffeine. Longer boiling times, on the other hand, make sure that the most caffeine is extracted. Amino acids. These add to the umami, or rich, taste of the tea. They break down slowly, which keeps the general taste of the tea balanced. Knowing these rates of breakdown helps you understand why brewing at different times gives you different tastes, strengths, and health benefits. Different people have different favorite brewing times. There are various ways that people like to drink black tea. Based on different tastes, here are some ideas. 1. For a cool and light tea. Let the tea steep for a short time if you like your tea light and refreshing. How to do it? Tea leaves. Use 1 tea bag or 1 teaspoon of dried black tea. Temperature of the water. Bring water to a boil and let it cool down to about 93 degrees Fahrenheit, 200 degrees Celsius. Time to brew. Steep for 1 to 2 minutes. The result is, this is a light, delicate tea with mild tastes and less caffeine. 2. For a tea that is well balanced and tasty. A medium length of time is best for making a cup that is well balanced and full of taste. This is how it's done. Tea leaves. Use 1 tea bag or 1 teaspoon of dried black tea. Water temperature. Bring water to a boil and pour it straight over the tea. Time to brew. Steep for 3 to 4 minutes. Result. A well-rounded tea with the right amount of caffeine, power, and flavor. 3. For a strong and tough tea. Long boiling times are best for people who like strong tea. This is how it's done. Tea leaves. Use 1 tea bag or 1 teaspoon of dried black tea. Heat the water to a boil, then pour it over the tea. Time to brew. Steep for 5 minutes or more. The result is a strong, full-bodied tea that has the most caffeine and antioxidants extracted, but it may be more bitter. Useful advice for making black tea. Here are some more tips to make sure you get the best black tea, no matter what time you like to brew it. Quality of tea. Use tea bags or tea leaves of good quality. Quality can have a big effect on how good your tea tastes and how healthy it is for you. Quality of the water. Use clean, filtered water. The water you use changes how your tea tastes. Ratio of tea to water. Most of the time, 1 teaspoon of tea leaves to 1 cup of water is a good amount. Make changes based on your personal style. Temperature control. Most black tea is made with hot water, but letting the water cool a bit can keep the tea from getting too bitter. Time. Use a timer to ensure you don't over or under brew your tea. It only takes 1 minute to make a change. Do not be afraid to try different cooking times and methods to find the one that suits your taste the best. Why black tea is good for you? Putting aside the time it takes to make, black tea is good for you in many ways. These are some important ones. Health of the heart. Drinking black tea regularly may be good for your heart. Lack of flavonoids in black tea can make you less likely to get heart disease. Antioxidant properties. Black tea has a lot of antioxidants, which help fight free radicals and lower oxidative stress. Health of the digestive system. Black tea has tannins that can help digestion and make the digestive system feel better. Awareness of mind. Black tea is a good choice for people who need a mental boost because the caffeine in it can help you concentrate and stay mentally alert. Managing your weight. Some studies show that black tea can help people control their weight by speeding up their metabolism and burning more fat. How long you let black tea steep has a big effect on its taste, strength, caffeine level, vitamin levels, and health benefits in general. You can change the brewing time to get the perfect cup of tea for your tastes and needs. Whether you like a light, delicate cup or a strong, powerful brew, understanding the science behind boiling and trying different times will help you enjoy drinking tea more and get the most out of this popular drink. So, get your favorite tea leaves and a timer, and start making. You'll find the best black tea for you. Thank you for joining us on Herbalist Channel today. We hope you found this video informative and inspiring on your journey toward better health and well-being. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos on herbal remedies, health tips, and nutritious recipes. Remember, nature has provided us with incredible healing properties through plants, and we're here to explore them together. Until next time, stay healthy, stay happy, and stay tuned to Herbalist Channel. Take care!